What is up, guys? Welcome back to Cult Town. Today we're going to be playing some Lava Hound. So, of course, Lava Hound, much better now that Exe and Witch are no longer super strong. And then this is also taking advantage of the very strong Night Witch. And then you use barbs as a good solid defense. And they also kind of have the poison fireball bait aspect that goes along with Night Witch. We're going to, of course, looking to be minoring as the Lava Hound pops to tank for the pups. And... this is a really heavy beatdown deck, so we can wait, although we probably will cycle like a miner or a barb barrel before 2 minutes, since we don't have a lava hound in cycle. If you had a lava hound in cycle, I would say you're content just waiting till double. Bum, 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 bum. So it appears he is also content to wait, so we'll wait until near the 2 minute mark and then just toss out miner. Try to always make sure with this deck too that you always have at least one ground counter in hand. So don't, like, for instance, if he defends my miner with any ground unit, really, like a mini P.E.K.K.A, a Valkyrie, a Knight, I shouldn't Night Witch it. I should Mega Minion to keep a ground defense in hand. All right, so we'll toss out miner. Lava's next in hand now. Oh, wow. I'm a fortune teller. All right, so we Mega Minion, we don't Night Witch. Because he could... I wonder if it's Expo. Usually has Ice Golem. It's not that crazy of a change. But yeah, just... Okay. Pump's weird. Archer's pump. It's odd. Alright, so we can toss out Night Witch, and now we have three ground counters in hand. This is a weird deck. Maybe it's like Giant Sparky pump. Okay, it's got to be freeze. So I basically just played free barbs because the graveyard did no damage to it. So I'm lobbying at the bridge here, and I'm gonna minor archers. All right, we'll go with this, and then I'll still minor archers. Okay. I'm gonna poison so. Oh yeah, I honestly forgot he had pump. Alright, he probably can't defend it though after playing that Knight. If he freezes, I have barb barrel ready. It's gotta be freeze with how he's playing his graveyards. I don't even need to do anything to that. That was really expensive by him, so we have a really good lead here. Just be ready to attack. We have no reason, we have no way to reset Inferno Tower. We shouldn't support that anymore. He's going to try to go all in here. I have poison though, so. Alright, we just need to, we can't save the Lava Pound, so we're just going to try to get the support units through. And that should be enough. Yes, it is. Of course, having poison help there, although I only use it once on defense because we didn't need to the other times, but it's a good one. Can't stop Inferno Tower, but we can still get the dub. I'm just gonna poison this. With huts, of course, I always try to poison as late as possible so you cancel as many waves as possible while still hitting the first wave. I guess I'll just Mega. Okay, then. This is going to be kind of annoying. My Hog defense is not the best. I really wish I hadn't Mega'd. If I hadn't Mega'd, I could have lobbed it at the bridge right here. I'm still going to attack with this, though. I mean, he just went 8 Elixir into Barbs and... they didn't get super low, so. Alright, so we're up 4 Elixir, although he does have a Magic Archer down. I know we're up 4 Elixir because he played that Bomber the second and he had the Elixir to play it. So we're up 4. We'll be up 2 after we Barb Barrel this. Or we'll have a Counter Push, maybe? Alright. I mean, we're still up because he keeps on overcommitting with his hogs. That's an air defense. I'll just Lava Hound. Hopefully this stops in tower range. I don't think it's going to, though. I think it's going to... maybe. Alright, that's actually perfect. Nice. I don't have to play Mega Minion too early now. I just need to be ready to minor his Magic Archer. Okay, that's an easy poison. There's the Magic Archer. I think this is worth it to keep the pups alive, even if I do accidentally activate King Tower earlier. Yeah, that was worth. And it didn't activate, so. Yeah, there we go. And then we go here after he freezes, and then we bar barrel that away. I mean, we still lose a lot, but I think if I'm definitely gonna lob out in the middle. We have a lot of pressure right here. That's a good bomber by him. He doesn't really have, now that Skeleton's Army's out of hand, he doesn't really have a great catch there for my miner. So the pups will do quite a bit of damage. Obviously, he's going to take tower if he wants to. I should still probably force his freeze. I think I will. Yeah, I'll force his freeze there. Just makes him waste more elixir, and I still have a lot of pressure from the barbs. He can try to attack here, but the tower's full HP, so I should be fine. My Lava Hound timings have been great. I'm going to play this really far back and then poison this. Maybe I'll wait and see if he gives me poison value on the Magic Archer. That arrow played over here and I can just kill it. Okay, that's poison value. There we go. Good weight. That was a weird defensive freeze. Mega Minion locks? Oh, almost. This freeze is out of hand. So I obviously barbs here if he goes hog. We'll just poison that. We can play defensive here and win by damage. I mean, even if he freezes, he won't do that much damage, and we'll have a big counter push. And we can stack troops since he doesn't have a big spell that does damage that way. We'll defensive freeze here. Or defensive poison, I mean. If he freezes this, we Lava Hound in front, and I'm pretty sure there's no way he defends. Night Witch counter push. When your opponent's at low elixir, very scary. We'll play this because he's going to try to scar me. Ooh, he just has to go for bomber instead. He should have scarmed me right there. Now it's a little bit too late, probably. To save his Magic Archer, obviously. And then we'll go for another Night Witch. Miner as close as possible. See if we can get the tank. And we are able to take the dub. Don't even need to win on damage in tiebreaker. Alright, so Ice Spirit, he probably has a quick cycle-ish deck, and I have big heavy deck, so we wait. This is probably Expo. We're pretty weak to Expo. We will have to tower trade. Okay. So it's 2.6. I don't know. This is actually harder than you would think. If we make it till double, we should be okay. Lava Hound, the same lane he's attacking. This is very easy for him to defend. We'll just have to go Night Witch. Protecting his Musketeer as Hog 2.6 players be doing. And then we'll just, I don't know, we'll have to minor that, we're at 10. hoping that wouldn't get a hit. Yeah, now he musketeers again, and that's gonna be annoying. I think we can Lava Hound, though. If he hogs our land, we completely ignore it and go all in. I think I want bats, and then I'll miner. Actually, I'm gonna baby drag since it's so far up. That's really expensive for him to kill there. And now he has no fireball on hand, so we're gonna tank for the pups and we're just gonna group everything on top of each other. Yeah. Yeah, that was a bad fireball. I mean, he wanted to get rid of the Night Witch, so I guess it wasn't bad, but we took advantage of it. Good fireball by him. Really easy prediction. I had nothing else in cycle, but maybe I could have delayed it a bit. I don't know. He'll probably take this tower. We just have to attack. Alright, that's dead. We're not going to give him too much fireball value. We're going to poison this. And we will need to go up. Alright, tower's dead. Actually, poison doesn't take that, we lose. Well, if I can get a miner off, we'll see. Oh no, a bad hit, it takes. Okay. That was terrifying. I have to not give him the fireball. If he hogs here, we're not going to barbs. We have enough tower HP that we can just mega minion. And if he fireballs and it doesn't hit, if he was to go hog, it would have lost him the game. But I don't think he's gonna hog. That's probably bad timing for him. I don't know. We should be good here. We can go barbs here, and it'll take long enough that I don't think he gets the. Okay, he decides to just take that fireball. I mean, that should be a lot of damage now, I guess. I don't know if the barbs are worth it. Yeah, I don't know. You just go super aggressive. This, I really don't think this... If I had a pool, like if I had a cage, I think this matchup is good. This matchup's really not good for me. It's just not. We can maybe win here. Alright, he choked. That was a bad hog. I'm pretty sure he could have defended. Oh well, we'll take the dub. Ugh. I mean, I didn't really do anything wrong. The one fireball prediction by him was really nice. And then he didn't overcommit afterwards trying to do the same thing twice. So, I mean, he played that really well, but honestly, it's pretty difficult. We don't have a... I mean, if you have a balloon, it should be easy. But without a balloon, it's kind of hard to pressure. Lava Miner is usually good against it, but Lava Miner usually has Cage. If I had Cage, it would be easy, because then I can set up a Cage before I Lava Hound, and there's no pressure on me. But when they have barbs, it's difficult, I would say. All right, guys, this is going to be a bit of a shorter video, because I got stuff I got to do today. Going to go hang out with friends and stuff. But thank you guys for watching. That's 3 wins in a row, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.